Hey everybody, Dr. Robin here again with my 5-minute coaching video for this week. We are all still on lockdown for COVID all over the world. We have this new strain going around, so it looks like we are going to have to readjust to life and how we view things, which is what I'm always talking about, right? So today I want to talk to you about how to be kind to yourself while we're growing and transforming. I can just say, from my personal opinion, the human race is transforming. We are changing the way we think, the way we feel, the way we live on this planet. We're in a major transition, in my personal opinion, from a both human and spiritual perspective. Okay? So what's that doing? Well, it's causing a lot of anxiety and a lot of stress, and mostly because a lot of us are having to rethink how we do everything, right? Everything has changed. Everything's different. Look, I haven't had a carrot haircut in months. I'm starting to get a little long in the tooth here, right? But this is life, right? Right now. So what I want to say is, this is a time to be kind to yourself. When we are in transformation, and in general, but especially in transformation, it can be so disturbing. It'll feel like the sand is shifting beneath our feet, right? Which is what we're feeling right now. But if you listened to my video last week about lemons and growth during adversity, this is another take on that. So we're going through adversity, and now what? It's a time to be kind to yourself. Think about how you talk to yourself. Would you say those things to a person? Would you say those things to your best friend? Probably not. And I want you to really think about this week what it is that you say to yourself and how you internalize that, because that will have everything to do with how well you process through this time. We tend to be really hard on ourselves when we're learning something new, when we're transforming. But if we can keep our mindset on the fact that we are in a growth pattern, I like that saying that we are spiritual beings having a human experience, right? Part of this process is life's lessons, right? Every minute, in my personal opinion, again, is either a choice or a life lesson or a combination of, okay? That's all this is. That's what this experience is about, is being there for one another and taking care of other people. But we tend to treat people better than ourselves. I'm not talking about narcissism and being selfish. That's not what I'm saying. I'm talking about not beating yourself up, not telling yourself shameful things that make you feel bad about yourself, not picking apart the things you do and don't do right. And you know what? The reality is, if you sat down in a day and wrote down everything you do, you probably do 99% right. And you make maybe one mistake. But we, as humans, and the way our brains work, the way we encode information, we tend to just fixate on the negative, because that emotion is so much more powerful in the human brain than a positive emotion. That's why we need 10 positives to offset a negative, right? So the thing to do, what I'm working on, because I'm human too, and everybody, is be kind to yourself, love yourself, give yourself the patience and the consideration and the grace, right? We all need some grace right now. Oh my God, look at my hair. I need some grace, right? We need some grace for one another, for ourselves, because if we don't have grace in ourselves, it's really, really hard to give it to other people. And this is a time where people need love and understanding and consideration, because we are going through it. We're going through it. So love yourself. Be kind to yourself. Say good things to yourself. Reward yourself for the good things you do. Again, I'm not talking about irresponsible or narcissistic behavior. I'm just talking about the words you say to yourself, the things you do for yourself. Take a break. Take a minute. I'm the worst, right? People in the mental health or medical field or whatever, teachers, a lot of people, we tend to be self-sacrificing. So we put other people first, and then we tend to be the last. We can't do that. We need to love ourselves, and it starts with what we say to ourselves. So embrace that wrinkle. God, I got plenty. Embrace that crooked tooth, the hair that doesn't work, or the job that's new that you don't understand, or this whatever's going on in your life that's transforming and different and changing, embrace it. And be graceful and loving to yourself. Dr. Robin signing off. Go to Dr. Dr. Robin, R-O-B-I-N, Goins, G-O-I-N-S.com. Sign up for one of my classes. Sign up for a session, or just take one of the free programs that I have. Listen to some lectures, whatever. But enjoy your Christmas holiday. Dr. Robin signing off. Have a great holiday. I'll see you next week.